For the Wismann car motion system, we needed switches so that the trucks can choose between different routes. Unfortunately, the Wismann switch is not yet available, and the price at €50 is quite steep. We will show you how to make 8 switches for less than 3 official ones. The idea is to print the different switches and then use a servo to move the selector to the different positions. We could design the switch ourselves, but a quick search yielded exactly what we needed. We could buy these files for €10. For this servo, the manual recommended a 9-gram servo. There was even a link to an AliExpress shop where we found an equivalent one at Elefun, the Power HD1900A for 79 NOK, which is €7.50. Also, shipping was much faster than from China, and the review for the recommended servo were not that great. You can save some money by shopping around, but it might not be worth the hassle. For controlling the servo, we use an ASUS Switch Below 3 servo with 8 outputs. Unfortunately, this decoder only allows 2 end positions, which works fine for simple Y and T junctions. If you really need more than 2 positions, which you would need for a larger crossing, you will need another decoder, like the old Switch Below 2 servo, which can steer up to 4 different positions per servo. So the decoder for 8 servo costs €65. A cheaper alternative might be to use an Arduino, that's more a solution for really tech-savvy people. The first thing was to 3D print the mounts, selector and the lid. We had some troubles printing the lids, but since we are building the street out of a paper sheet, we dropped the printing of the lids after the first prototype. To mount, you need to drill a 32mm hole in the baseboard. Unfortunately, the proper drill didn't work very well with the MDF board we are using and created a total mess. So we had to use a hole saw where it could only in 30 or 35mm. So we drilled with 30mm from the top and 35mm from the bottom. The rest was removed with a file. The servos are installed in the mount. On the selector, we put a small piece of magnet strip. The selector is then glued with one small drop of super glue on the servo. Before doing that, power up the servo to be sure it's in the standard position. Then install the servo in the layout and connect it to the decoder. You can program the decoder directly using the buttons on the device and navigate through the menu, or using a lock programmer, or by programming the CVs. If you choose another brand, you will have to check how it's done there. If you cannot see the selector because you are lying under the layout, you will need someone to tell you the position while configuring it. Later we mounted the decoder properly so it could be controlled from our central. If you prefer physical buttons, you can connect some to the decoder. During testing, we found out that driving in merging direction, trucks will safely continue even if the switch is in the wrong position. So the total for 8 switches were €10 for the files, 60 for the servos, 65 for the decoder, and maybe €1 for the resin, making a total of €136. For that price, you get barely 2 original. And for the next one we will need, we can reuse the files. If you liked this video, then subscribe to see more in the upcoming Car Motion series.